Hello guys, I'm recording this episode from an unusual place than I usually do. I'm on my vacation in Croatia right now, and I wanted to do a video on the topic of traveling and insomnia, because I know this is pretty important or like interesting topic for anyone who is struggling with their sleep, because there is a lot of worry about how am I going to enjoy my life, enjoy my vacation, enjoy my trips if I have problems sleeping. So I just want to cover like small part of it, because there is so much to say about the topic of traveling in the context of insomnia. So you know, maybe I will later on dedicate more videos to that topic, but for now I just want to stop at this particular thing, and it is waking up early for whatever reason. You have to wake up much earlier than your normal wake up time. Let's say you have to wake up at 3 a.m. to catch an early flight, or you need to drive somewhere far away, and you just have to be up way early. And that creates this kind of situation that we obviously know that we have so little time to sleep, and naturally people feel pressured. They feel worried, they feel more anxious about, you know, what if they will not get enough sleep, how they're going to perform the next day, what if they have to drive the next day. They worry about how they will be able to perform the, you know, this kind of like important tasks. And I just want to share with you three kind of points to this situation, so to help you maybe get some clarity on how to approach things like that. And I want to start the first topic with the story, actually how we prepared for this trip, because we had to wake up at 3 a.m. Because the drive is very long, and my husband was supposed to drive, so he went to bed earlier than I did, and I still had some preparations to do. I had to do final packing and prepare sandwiches for the way, so I ended up going to bed around 12. So, you know, like when you go to bed at 12 and you know that you have to wake up at 3 a.m., then, you know, like it's pretty limiting time. And in my experience, I know that when person is really pressed by time, it is normal that there will be, you know, that you might be more awake than you would like to. So I went to bed without any kind of like expectations on the night, and I just was thinking about something that I have to still like take on the trip, so that I won't forget something. And as I was, you know, just thinking about random stuff, I just transitioned to sleep, and then I woke up with alarm. But what is interesting is that my husband, who never had problems with sleep, who was, you know, considered to be a good sleeper, he actually said that he barely slept that night, and he fell asleep just before, you know, like the alarm. And even though he had more time, he took more time for sleep, he didn't use that time like in a way that he would expect. So basically he probably slept even less than I did. But I want to share like this important learning here is that it is so normal for anyone, not only people with insomnia, to sleep less on this kind of high pressure nights like this one, when you have to wake up early. It is natural that we feel somewhat pressured, and any person, regardless of whether they have insomnia or not, they will feel pressured to be up at certain, you know, hour, and they might have this, you know, they might have some trouble falling asleep or staying asleep. So we need to kind of like normalize the whole situation and think about this. When we have to wake up on this nights like this, it is even expectable that we will have some trouble sleeping, so that we don't feel that we are doing something wrong, or there's something wrong, something is wrong with us when we don't sleep. It is so natural to have that. And I have actual proof of my husband, who never had problems with insomnia, actually, you know, showing that yes, on these kind of nights when you are limited with sleep, then it might happen that you will have less sleep. And then the second point is that it's not always the case, right? It's not always the case that when we have like limited time, that means that we will not sleep at all. It's not a rule. Actually, the outcome of the night can be different. It can be anything. It can be the night when you sleep with no problems the whole time, or it could be the night when you slept half of the time, or it could be the night that when you just didn't sleep the whole time. It's all expected. Everything is kind of like considered to be like normal on the you know, circumstances like this. So that doesn't mean that by accepting that, you know, okay, I will not be probably asleep or like this night, then that means that I will be sleeping, the night will be good. It's not the case, because then people get into this kind of like a rabbit hole. They begin to think, they begin to accept the wakefulness, secretly hoping that they will sleep, and therefore it leads to another frustration, because then if they happen to be awake at night, then they will go like, well, I did acceptance, why I still didn't get even like a minute of sleep, you know. So there is like I just want to, you know, that we need to be aware of that it doesn't, you know, mindset or some affirmations don't control sleep, and we need to embrace the unpredictability of the outcome of the night. The night can be different, especially the pressure night when we have to sleep, and any outcome is, you know, is an okay outcome. It's not, doesn't show that you're doing something wrong or that you're somehow different. So I hope that this point is kind of clear. We cannot predict that, we cannot, you know, we cannot ensure that we will sleep on certain nights and in a certain amount of time, in certain amount of sleep we'll get. And then the third point, and I think it's a very important one, is understanding that during insomnia our thinking is always directed at either past or future. So basically we always focus on things that we cannot control, possibly cannot control. We begin to feel frustrated in case we didn't sleep much, so we keep thinking and focusing on the stuff that already happened, the fact that yes, I didn't sleep that time, and now you worry about that, and then you also worry about how that will affect you in the future. So sometimes people feel even frightened even before that event has happened, let's say whether you slept or not, but they like even the evening before they feel scared, like how am I going to drive the next day, how am I going to, you know, handle a situation if I will be super tired, I will not be able to perform my task, and so on. And here is the thing, you don't know how the next night, the next day will be. And how about we deal with the situation when it happens, when we deal with what we have currently on our plate and just focus on the present moment. If we have, let's say we didn't sleep much and we are tired, so we are going to deal with that. We have choice, we don't have to do something like that doesn't make sense to us, and let's say when we feel like, you know, but then I just, you know, if I didn't sleep and I feel like super tired and so on and I have to drive, they feel like they are like there's not no way out, then they will have to drive and endanger themselves of, you know, like nodding off and falling asleep on the road. But that's not the case, because when that situation happens and when it's that situation comes, and then you know that yes, I didn't sleep much and I feel super tired, I feel sleepy, you can make a decision that makes sense to you in that moment. You can decide that okay, I'm stopping at the gas station and I'm just taking some time to rest, or maybe I'm just taking a coffee, or I will ask, let's say if you're traveling with someone can drive for you. So there is always some choice to, that we can make, and it doesn't mean that we have to, you know, stick to our, you know, plan that okay, I just need to drive, or I just need to, you know, keep enjoying it and so on. We can deal with situation when it comes, and if it happens that you don't feel tired, you actually feel fine, it's also great, you know, like then that means that it's another proof that, you know, the sleepless nights doesn't mean always that you are going to have a terrible day. But just know that you have freedom to choose how to react to the situation when it actually happens. Always deal with what you have currently, and because again, as I said in the second point, is that we cannot predict how the night will turn out to be, and the same way we cannot predict how the day will turn out to be, we just don't know. And to think about, like, prepare for the scenarios sometimes can be actually, like, prepare for scenarios, it's good to have some plan B in mind. Like, you know that okay, if you have, let's say, to drive and you are afraid that you, like, what if you will be tired, then you can think of ways how you can deal with that situation, and when the situation actually comes, you already have the plan. But just worrying about, like, just that kind of like, okay, I'm going to be tired and I'm just, and this is the end of the world, and there is nothing I can do about that, this is something that can create unnecessary worry. But just know that you're free to choose how to approach the situation when the situation comes, and there will be no one who will tell you, or you're doing it wrong. If you need rest, you can rest. If you don't need rest and you think like you can go on, like you can just go on with your, you know, with your day, like unaffected by whatever like amount of sleep you got. So just know that, you know, that we can always deal with the present moment, and knowing that insomnia thinking is always focused on either past or the future, and bringing our attention back to the present moment, back to reality, being in touch with the reality the way how it is, not the way how we want it to be or how we don't want it to be, because that's the thing that creates the suffering. That's the thing that creates more worries. Stuff that hasn't yet happened or has happened and we cannot control anymore. That's what basically the majority of our struggles with insomnia is. But when the actual situation comes, we need to realize that we can deal with this however we feel is right. And I just talked a lot, and I just want to kind of recap what I just said. So the first thing, like, we need to understand when we face the situation, when we have to wake up early, is that, you know, it is expected to have any sort of night. Like, even if it's like a night when you didn't sleep on this kind of pressure night, it's okay, it's completely okay. And even people without insomnia can experience that. They can be awake the whole time, and that doesn't mean that there is something is wrong. It's just how pressure works on sleep. The second thing is that we cannot possibly predict how the night will be. Night can be all sorts of ways. It doesn't mean that if you have like no, you know, or very little time for sleep, it doesn't mean that you will be awake the whole time. It can happen, but it doesn't mean that it will nest, like, as a rule that it will happen. It can be anything. Embrace the unpredictability of the sleep itself. And the third thing is that keep your focus on the present moment and know that you can deal with the situation as it unfolds, and you have a choice how to react. I hope it was helpful for you guys. Let me know in comments if it made sense, or if you have some interesting like stories to share about the vacation and sleep. And I will see you soon. Bye.